In this video, I'll introduce you to the planar and network surfaces. I'll start with the planar surface. So click on planar. Now it'll ask you for the first corner of the planar surface and the opposite corner of the planar surface. Now when you take the cursor over here, you can see that it is a planar surface. And when you change the visual style to shaded, you can see that there is a surface. Hence, we have got a surface with a zero thickness. Planar surfaces can also be created from an existing 2D object. For example, I'll click on planar again, and there is an object option in this, so click on object and I'll select this rectangle and give an enter. You can see that the software creates a surface out of this rectangular object. Now I'll change the visual style back to 2D wireframe. In the wireframe representation, you can see that the surface is made up of a number of lines in the horizontal as well as in the vertical direction. And these two lines are controlled using two variables. You can control the values of those variables using the options dialog box. So right-click the mouse on the screen, click on options, and you will get this dialog box. Here in the 3D modeling tab, you will get options to control this line. In U direction, it is 6, and in V direction, it is 6. Now I'll give higher values for these variables from 6 to 10. I'll click on apply and OK. Next, I'll create planar surface again, but from this curvilinear shape. So click on object option and select this shape and give enter. Now you can see that there are 10 lines in the horizontal as well as in the vertical direction. Similarly, you can create a planar surface out of this circle. So click on planar, give enter, and select the circle and enter. Hence, planar surface is essentially confined to a single plane, but the network surface tool creates a surface connecting curves in 3D space. So let's see that. I have already created curves here to create network surface, but those curves are hidden. What I'll do is right click on the screen, then isolate, end object isolation. Now you will see these curves here. These curves are created in space. Now I'll click on network surface tool. So it'll ask you to select the curves or surface edges in the first direction. Here I have two curves in this direction. I'll select the first one and the second one. Give enter. Then I'll select the curves in the other direction, which is this particular direction. I'll select the curves 1, 2, 3 and 4 and give enter. Now it has created a surface connecting all these curves in space. Now I'll change the visual style to realistic and you can see the surface. Hence, by using network surface, you can create non-coplanar surfaces in space connecting objects such as splines, 2D or 3D curves. So that's all about planar and network surfaces. Click on the link provided at the upper right corner of this video to learn more about a typical application of network surfaces. Please hit the like button if you find this video informative. Please do subscribe to my YouTube channel Sabir CAD if you haven't subscribed already, and hit the bell icon and click on all to get instant updates on my future video uploads. Until I catch you with another informative video on CAD, bye bye and take care. Thank you so much for your time.